क्लास 12th सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स थर्ड चैप्टर काइनेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस एंड रेडिएशन. फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी फर्स्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. वी नो दैट देर आर थ्री कॉमन स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर लाइक सॉलिड लिक्विड एंड गैसेस. द गैस लॉज that is Boyle's law, Charles' law and Gay-Lussac's law are given as the first one that is Boyle's law. The volume of given mass of gas is inversely proportional to its pressure at constant temperature. Second, Charles' law that is volume of given mass of gas is directly proportional to its temperature at constant pressure. Third is Gay-Lussac's law, which states that the pressure of given mass of gas is directly proportional to its temperature at constant volume. So these are the three gas laws. If we combine all these three gas laws, then we will get the ideal equation. We will get the ideal equation for a fixed mass of the gas, and therefore the ideal gas equation for fixed mass of gas will be given as PV proportional to T, or it can also be written as P1 V1 upon T1 equal to P2 V2 upon T2. So this equation gives the ideal gas equation for the fixed mass of gas. Instead of that, if you consider the n moles of the gas, then for n moles of the gas, the equation will be written as PV proportional to nt, or it will be written as PV equal to nRT, where n will be given as the number of moles, n will be given as mass of the gas m divided by its molar mass m0, mass of the gas m upon molar mass m0, that will be written as n by na. Now in this relation, PV equal to nRT, in that ideal gas equation, this R represents the gas constant, and whose value is R equal to 8.31 joule per mole per Kelvin. Now, if KB represents the Boltzmann constant, then the ideal gas equation will be written as PV equal to NKBT, or R will be equal to Na into KB, where Na represents Avogadro's number and KB is Boltzmann constant. Their values are Avogadro's number Na equal to 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 molecules per mole. Similarly, Boltzmann constant KB will be equal to 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23 joule per Kelvin. So these are the constants which are considered in case of the study of gases. Now let us see the next point, that will be behavior of a gas. If you consider any gas, then what will be the behavior of that gas? So let us see behavior of the gas. A gas enclosed in a container is characterized by its pressure, volume, temperature. So the parameters like pressure, volume and temperature will be very, very important for any enclosed gas. This is the macroscopic description of the gas. Now we know that the particles of the gas, that is the molecules, are in constant motion, and it is very difficult to understand the behavior of the gas in terms of motion of the single gas particle, since the gas particles will be very very small, and hence it will be very very difficult to understand the behavior of that gas. And hence the number of gas particles, that is molecules in the gas, is so large. The number of molecules will be so large, about 10 raised to 23 particles per meter cube, that is 10 raised to 23 molecules per meter cube, that any attempt to relate the macroscopic parameters like pressure, volume and temperature with motion of individual particles will be useless or fruitless. And hence certain assumptions are made regarding the particles of the gas. Then the averages of the physical quantities over large number of particles involved are obtained, and these averages are finally related to the macroscopic parameters of the gas. So this is regarding the behavior of the gas. Now let us see the next point, which is important one, and that is what is ideal gas and real gas. So what is that ideal gas and what is real gas, that we will have to study now. So a gas which obeys ideal gas equation at all the pressures and temperatures is called as the ideal gas. A gas which obeys the ideal gas equation at all the pressures and temperatures is called an ideal gas. Now if you consider the ideal gas, then the intermolecular interactions between its molecules are absent. In an ideal gas, the intermolecular interactions are absent. Real gases are composed of atoms or molecules which do not interact with each other. The real gases are composed of atoms or molecules which do not interact with each other. Hence, no real gas is an ideal gas. If the atoms or molecules of a real gas are so far apart that there is practically no interaction between its atoms and molecules, then the real gas is considered as an ideal gas. But this will happen at very very low density of the real gas. At low pressures or at high temperatures, the molecules are far apart and hence molecular interactions are negligible. Under these conditions, the behavior of real gases is close to that of an ideal gas. So this will be regarding the behavior of ideal and real gases. And now let us go for next term, that is mean free path. So in order to explain the concept of mean free path, two diagrams are given here. In the first diagram, the dispersed molecules of the gas are given. The spreading of the gas molecules, that is dispersed gas molecules, are shown in the first diagram, while in the second diagram, a single molecule is in motion. So its motion is given throughout the gas. Here only one molecule will be in motion in the second diagram. So let us see what is that mean free path. When a molecule, if you consider, then it will be in the state of random motion throughout the gas. But we know that the molecules of the gas are in random motion, such as the Brownian motion, and therefore when a molecule approaches another molecule, there is a repulsive force between them, due to which the molecules behave as small rigid spherical particles. This leads to elastic collisions between the molecules. Therefore, both speed, that is magnitude of velocity, and the direction of motion of these molecules change suddenly. There will be continuous change in the magnitude as well as direction of the velocity of that molecule. The molecules also collide with the walls of the container, and the molecules exert force on each other as well as on the walls of the container only during the collisions. Thus, in between two successive collisions, the molecule will travel. Suppose that first of all molecule is here, then second molecule is here at some distance from this molecule, so that here there will be collision. Now again it will travel along this path and it will collide with the another molecule. So between two successive collisions, it will travel a straight line path. So this is one straight line path, this will be another straight line path, this will be next straight line path, this will be again next straight line path. Like this, between two successive collisions, that molecule will travel along a straight line path with constant velocity. And this each straight line path between two successive collisions, so in this case each straight line path between two successive collisions will be called as free path. And therefore, if you consider this free path, from this the average distance traveled by the molecule between two successive collisions is called as the mean free path. The average distance traveled by the molecule with constant velocity between two successive collisions is called as mean free path, denoted by lambda. Now, what will be the expression for that mean free path? So for that purpose, let N be the capital N represents the number of molecules of the gas, and phi represents the volume of the gas. Similarly, density rho of the gas will be then given as N by phi. So N by phi, that is equal to rho, that is the density of the gas. Now, the expression for mean free path of that gas will be given as lambda equal to 1 upon square root of 2 pi d square into N by phi. This N by phi represents rho. And therefore, alternately, we can write lambda equal to 1 upon square root of 2 pi d square rho, or rho will be replaced by N by phi. And therefore, from this expression, some of the conclusions we can draw. So these conclusions are, higher the density of the gas, more will be the collisions between the molecules, and smaller will be the mean free path. So in that expression, if you consider density, then it is at denominator, and therefore from this the first conclusion is, higher the density of the gas, more will be the collisions between the molecules, and smaller will be the mean free path. That is, from this expression, lambda will be inversely proportional to square root of rho, or square root of N by phi, that is density. Second one, in that expression, at the denominator d square is there. That d is nothing but the diameter of that molecule, and therefore the second conclusion will be, smaller the size of the molecule, that is smaller the diameter of that molecule, less is the chance of collisions. There will be a less chance of collisions, and longer will be the mean free path, that is mean free path will be large. And therefore, second conclusion, according to second conclusion, again we can say that lambda is inversely proportional to square root of d square. So this will be about the mean free path of the gas molecules.